Telescopes are basically the light buckets which helps us to collect the photons from the sky. The main functions of the telescope are obtaining the high angular resolution image, and this resolution increases with the size of the primary mirror of the telescope, and also it helps us to collect a maximal amount of light so that we can study fainter objects. Bigger the size of the telescope, that means bigger the size of the primary mirror, we would be able to collect more amount of light. Broadly, there are two kinds of telescopes. One is space-based telescopes, other one is ground-based telescopes. Space-based telescopes are typically launched to space, and the ground-based telescopes are constructed on different locations on the Earth. While constructing this telescope, choosing a good site for this telescope is very important, because the weather should be dry at the location, and the sky should be cloudless and clear, and it should be far away from the city, and the wind flow should be very stable so that there are no blurring of the images. In this poster, there are few telescopes which are currently existing, and there are few telescopes which are upcoming. Like, for example, VLT, Atacama Large Millimeter Array, GTC, Bicep Keck Array are the currently existing telescopes which have different science goals. And James Webb Telescope, Large Synoptic Survey Telescope, GMT, TMT, and EELT are the next generation telescopes, that is, which are upcoming. So, Very Large Telescope Array consists of four 8.2 meter telescopes, and can work either individually or they can work all together to form a joint interferometer. They operate in the visible and infrared wavelength region of the electromagnetic spectrum. And these telescopes are run by European Southern Observatory. Atacama Large Millimeter Array consists of 66 radio dishes, and each of them are either 12 meter or 7 meter in diameter. And this radio interferometer is located in the Atacama Desert of Chile at an altitude of 5000 meters. And the main science goal of this is to observe first stars and galaxies and imaging of exoplanets. The other large telescope, that is, which is 10.4 meter in diameter, is Great Canary Telescope, which has 36 hexagonal segments in its primary mirror. And it observes in optical wavelength and also mid and near infrared wavelength region. This telescope is operated in a collaboration of Spain, Mexico, and University of Florida. The other famous telescope which is operating in the South Pole is Bicep Keck Array, which is an array of the telescope which is mainly interested to measure the B-mode polarization in the CMB, which is a signature of the inflation in early universe. It's a background imaging of cosmic extragalactic polarization telescope. And we also have another South Pole based balloon borne telescope, which is SPIDER, which is also trying to measure the P-mode polarization. So these are the currently existing telescopes which operate in different wavelength region and for different science goals. So the space telescope is James Webb Space Telescope, which is a successor mission to the Hubble Space Telescope. The primary mirror of this is a diameter of 6.5 meters, and it is made up of hexagonal segmented mirrors. And it was scheduled to be launched in October 2018, but it will be launched either late next year or early next to next year. This is a collaboration between NASA, European Space Agency, and Canadian Space Agency, and it will carry out observation in the mid-infrared wavelength region. And another important ground-based telescope is the Large Synoptic Survey Telescope. It is important because it is a wide-field survey telescope which is going to image the entire sky every few nights. So it will make the entire map of the universe. So it is an 8.4 meter telescope which is ground-based, and it is going to be in Chile, and the first light is expected to be either this year or early next year. After this, the three next generation telescopes are Jane Magellan Telescope, 30 meter telescope, and European Extremely Large Telescopes, where all three of them are 30 meter class telescope. The GMT is a primary mirror of GMT is 24.5 meters. It consists of 7 8.4 meter segments, and it is going to be in Chile, and the first light is expected to be in 2024. And it is a collaboration between the universities from USA, Australia, Korea, and Brazil. 30 meter telescope is the one which has a primary mirror of 30 meter in diameter, and this primary mirror is made up of 492 hexagonal mirrors, where each of them is 1.4 meter in size, and it will be located in Mauna Kea, Hawaii, USA, and it will operate in optical and near infrared wavelength region. Why TMT is important to us is because India is one of the collaborating nation in 30 meter telescope. India will be responsible for polishing of 100 of these mirror segments and also developing of actuators to control these mirrors. The next one, which is the largest optical telescope which is going to be built in the world, is an European extremely large telescope where the primary mirror is of diameter 39.3 meters. And it will consist of 798 hexagonal segments, which are of size 1.4 meter each. This is going to be situated in Chile, and the first light is expected to be in 2024. And this telescope is by the European Southern Observatory collaboration. So these are the next generation telescopes, and these the first four are the currently existing telescopes. Thank you.